Krishna is basically emphasizing that we should think outside the box. The phrase "think outside the box" was coined by John Adair in the 60s, in the 20th century. It was in the context of a topographical puzzle where you have three dots in three rows and you would be asked to connect those three, all the 9 points, with just 4 lines. And those 4 lines can have only, each line can have only one connecting node, meaning you have to be able to go through it without taking your hand off. So you can't do this. That has too many points where the lines intersect each other. You can have only one connection point. So it has to be like this, or like this, and so on. It's not easy if you just immediately think the way we normally think. But the solution is quite elegant, and it exists. You can see that here. So, Krishna is saying, all these Brahma's creations, the ones that you can see and the ones that you can't see. See, that's where he's talking about matter and antimatter. Today, 28th of September, I heard on NPR about experiments that are being conducted to actually observe antimatter. So antimatter means you can use antiprotons and antielectrons to create an antihydrogen. So it's just the opposite of hydrogen, which is an antimatter. Very fascinating, I've been reading about it. So, but we have it in the Bhagavad Gita in the last couple of verses and today's verses. It says very clearly, the creations of Brahma that are observable and unobservable, they are all going to eventually vanish and then be recreated again. Just like you are going to go through birth and rebirth, that cycle. But if you don't want to do it, Krishna says, think outside of this universe that's made out of matter. There is a realm exists beyond Brahma's creation. And to achieve that, you can achieve that. You don't know what it is. Just like we talked about before, you can achieve that through pure devotion. So, we can use our mind, intellect, ego, and the soul, the conscience, to think beyond. It's possible, is what the verses are emphasizing. It may be difficult, obviously it is difficult, but as we can see, most of the other things that are mentioned here are scientifically being pursued now. Why not this additional aspect? That might also be possible. That's the gist of the next couple of verses.